Hi viewers, some people ask me how I was able to access the live data from my Honda DSL 1993 with my scanner. First, I found the basic information in my AIMS book, then the extra details on the web. After, I made my own wiring diagrams and I built my harness adapter using some old parts that I had. So today I am going to show you how I made my OBD1 to OBD2 harness prototype. I will also show you how I connect and use my scanner on my ECU P28. Okay, let's begin. When I built my harness, I double checked the pinout on my wiring diagram to make sure that I would not damage my ECU or my scanner. I also checked for good continuity between the connector contact pins and the OBD2 connector sockets. Since I'm using the Autel Scanner MD802, I also needed the external 12-volt battery voltage to power my scanner. For that, I added two electrical wires, ended with clamps, and ready to be connected on the battery poles. The positive connection is for the OBD2 connector socket number 16, and the negative connection is for the OBD2 connector socket number 4. Take note that I install one inline 3-amp fuse on the positive wire to protect my scanner. Now, let's look at the basic harness assembly. This is the 3-pin coupling connector assembled with the OBD2 coupling connector. The second branch on the harness is an option to supply the 12-volt power to my scanner. I can easily connect the second branch using the two small connectors. Notice the type of fuse that I used and also the type of clamps to connect on the battery poles. Another way to get the 12-volt power would have been to use a cigarette lighter plug. To locate the data link connector, you have to look in the passenger right lower side, just beside the ECU. Normally, the connectors are kept in a green holder to protect them. In my car, they are attached between the ECU and the blower fan. For normal scans, only the DLC connector needs to be connected with my small prototype harness. The second step is to connect my scanner cable with my small harness. The last step is to connect the clamps on the battery poles. Now that my scanner is powered, I have to use the arrow and OK buttons to make my selections. First, I select the square with the word scan and I press on OK. On the next selection, I select Asian and I press OK. In the car company display, I select Honda and I press OK. After the processing message, the select destination display gives 5 choices. In my case, I select Canada and I press OK. For the other countries, you have 4 other choices. The following display has to enter the VIN number. Then I press Show to access the VIN keyboard. I use the arrows and the OK to enter one by one the letters and the numbers to write the full VIN number. When it's completed, I select Finish. In the next display, I press Yes to save and continue. It is followed by the diagnostic display. I select Control Unit and I press OK. Now that I am in System Menu display, I select Engine PGMFI and I press OK. The scanner communicates with the ECM and the function menu is displayed. I select Live Data and I press OK to access the custom list. Finally, it shows a list of 30 types of live data that I can access. I hope that this presentation has given you some new ideas for your weekend projects. If I see that you liked it, I will produce another video including scanner readings that can help you to better tune your engine. Thanks for watching.